You ever wonder what a song that is not a spiritual song, what it would be like if it was? Well, here it goes.
Give your all to me, give my all.
That's what we're supposed to do for our beloved. And so let the ballad play on. And know that there's a lesson here. It's a beautiful lesson that all of our inspiration at the root truly is divine. And so when I heard heaven's loudest thunder of love rolling in, all the creation immediately had to stop groaning for the revelation of this most legend song written by John Legend. It elevates him to a place where he is a true legend among men. So let all those realizing that John also composed, he composed the most wondrous wonder, let them evermore see that his music attests to love's most marvelous marvel. And only then may our Lord of love's most passionate faith help us to see what's going on with that living hope's most incredible, beautiful mind. And let all ascending unto heaven's sparkling sapphire sea now begin the greatest magical mystery ride, until they start feeling so dizzy by the splendor of its majesty that they'll even feel like their heads are underwater, even though they're breathing in the life force of his fast-flowing living water just fine. And as they drink so freely of his living wine, of love's best hope, so will they find it so intoxifying that even the sanest of the sane will always let love drive them crazy, so that they feel right out of their minds. So let all of those of our living love, hope, and peace feel his refiner's fire strongest burn. Let him burn and let him shine as the glory of smiles turn frowns evermore right upside down. And then all of them shall love all of him evermore. And that is the truest truth. And the lyrics of that song is just so utterly beautiful. And I will be back in 1 second. Then all of them shall love all of him evermore, for he loves all of our ugliest curves and all of our most beautiful edges and all of our most perfect imperfections. So let such wise souls burning as love's brightest suns shine, let them give all of their heart unto our love of the ages, because he most certainly has already been giving all of himself and all of his love unto us before we ever loved him. And as they give their all unto him, since he is the beloved, the blessed, and the adored, then they shall clearly see that love is their end as well as their everlasting beginning. For with love divine, even when they seem like they're losing, yet shall they always still be winning, since all things, even the bad things, work together for our own good, as Romans 8:28 declares. And how many times has the Lord needed to tell us that to him, even when we're the ugliness of our worst moans and groans, even when that ugliness comes forth, we're still beautiful too. For if you hear his roaring lion of Zion, he's roaring louder than ever before, that even though the world has been beating many down, it's only their lovelessness that's their own downfall. Since unkindness done to others, like people that never give Daniel thumbs up on his video, God forgive you, But know that unkindness to others becomes their muse and their worst distractions, so that they'll never have love's rhythm as they always sing the blues, for all wanting love to be their all in all. For them, it's a different story. For them, the jubilee of jubilees, the unending celebration of love, for they can never stop singing, since loving hope starts ringing in their head. Because all of them loves all of him, and he loves all of their most imperfect imperfections. And as they give all to him, he shall evermore give his all unto them, because he is love, and love alone is our end and our beginning. And even when we're losing, we'll always still be winning, because all of us, all of love, as love gives all of love unto us, as we give love all the love we have. For these are the days to pull up anchor and to set sail for the love of the kingdom age, gospel truths ahead. For truly, as it is written, Eden is ahead, as the prophet Joel foretold. So it's time for love to be unshackled, so all of us can love all of him, so that everyone can plainly come to see that love isn't even love until it's so freely given away. So blessed are all those not fighting against their deepest desires for love, because at the end of the day, hope, peace, and faith is calling our names as if we were the only one. For whatsoever wishes need to come for our spiritual freedom, we might need to buy it at the very own cost of our liberated souls. And in the end, that's a very small price. So let all free birds now ascend by the eagle and the dove, as the lion and the lamb roar aloud, as that lamb-hearted lion of his noble prides of love tells all of his mindless sheep that they need to stop being loveless and unkind and ignorant to this messenger of love's finest end times message of love's endless glory. For if people will not give a thumbs up, they ain't even very Christian. So hearken now unto the Lamb of God, for he has always been lion-hearted in every incredible way, as his overflowing glory gushes out of the heavens. And in this hour, it is the hour of power, the hour to see the amazement that the Lord would be bringing our way. And as the music plays on, I'm going to end this video without any music, because I really want you to concentrate on what I am saying. Because the heavens floodgates are flooding, and God is pouring out his spirit upon all flesh, his love flowing. And if we will pay attention and if we will receive, then we can embrace love's greatest hopes that can be won, as death and all unloving ways can suddenly be turned back at hell's most fiery gates, because there at the gates all of our dross that needs to burn away by his refiner's fire will include all of our former prejudices, hypocrisies, and spiritual racism, which is only subtle hatefulness. I was a, I hate to say, I was a bigot all of my life, and I was a very hypocritical person. I thought everybody was going to hell, and I did not understand love. I didn't hear I didn't see the forest for the trees. So in this hour, as the band plays on, it's time to see that lovelessness has been our downfall, our distraction, and it's time to go in the opposite direction. So let the great jubilee of jubilees begin, And blessed are all those who will be brave enough to leave their comfort zones, for we're not even alive until we start to thrive. It's time to quit just surviving. It's time to thrive. It's time to prosper. So blessed are all those who are willing to let go of what they are so that they can finally become a much better version of what they can become instead. And let everyone wanting to celebrate now come to see with eyes wide open that the Lord's most blessed wind of all is now full, the wind of his blessedness, and the great tide of his love's very best understandings are now with all people seeking first the kingdom of love, the kingdom of Emmanuel, and his most passionate love in action as a child, for truly they shall see, and the blind eyes shall open in the name of our Prince of Peace. Amen.